I'm joined now by Assemblyman Declan O'Scanlon, champion of the defeat of the red light cameras, and now has got a new cause, raising that speed limit. Declan, good morning.
Bill, how are you?
I'm doing great. Tell me quickly, one of the objections, Declan, that comes up on this, and you and I have had this conversation about sound engineering and about the roads. Tell me, though, your experience when they raised the speed limit from 55 to 65, that the average speed of motorists didn't increase dramatically. The law just caught up with what they were already doing, which was safe.
That is exactly right. And that's been the experience, by the way, of the, I think, 37 other states that have continued to raise their speed limits to appropriate levels and levels that reflect the speeds at which people are already driving. It is a complete myth that people drive 10 miles an hour over speed limit. If you set a speed limit based on sound engineering criteria, you will get the greatest amount of compliance, you will get the greatest amount of safety with the least amount of punishment, and that should be the goal of government. But when we did the speed limit increase here in New Jersey, from 55 to 65, and I was very involved at that time, we heard the same lame argument you're going to hear now. Oh, people will just drive faster. Didn't happen. Mm-hmm. Speeds increased, I think, at average, average speeds increased by an average of about a mile an hour, maybe two in some places. In some areas, it actually went down. But there was no increase in speeds. Therefore, there was no impact, no negative impact in safety. There was, I believe, a positive impact in safety because you reduced the differential in speeds between people who were driving with the flow of traffic and the few people slavishly trying to adhere to the artificially low speed limit.
Right.
They came up. So you had less of a differential. When you have less of a differential in speeds, you have less overtaking and less other maneuvers that are more hazardous than that, overall speed going up.
And overall, over the past 10 years or so, the highways in New Jersey have gotten safer. So it didn't have an impact on safety, even just looking at the stats and the fatalities that have dropped.
Yeah, not just in New Jersey, but you see throughout the country, we have had a very uniform and steady decline in fatality rates throughout the past, 70 years. And when we actually ended the federal 55 mile an hour speed limit, the safety zealots came out of the woodwork. Oh my God, you're going to see massive carnage on the highways. They were proven absolutely, utterly wrong. We continued to see safety gains. So they were absolutely wrong then.
Yeah.
They'll be wrong now here. We just have to have the guts to overcome that and do the right thing.
Well, I applaud your courage taking this on. And it sounds like you've got your ducks in a row. You've got this focused. I will be interested to follow this as you work it through the assembly. I'd like to see hopefully this change take place sooner rather than later. Declan, I appreciate your time this morning and enjoy the weekend, and we'll stay in touch on this issue.
You too, and keep being out there for the cops.
I'm out there for them. You know it.